Welcome to my engraving studio. I'm Karri Gregor, the Artist Engraver. Glad you could join me today. In this video, I'm hand engraving the backstrap of a Colt third generation single action army pistol. Let's get into it. I was getting all ready to sketch out the top part of this backstrap when I noticed that this piece has a unique flaw, an imperfection which doesn't affect the operation of the gun, but it gives it character. The sides of this piece are not symmetrical as it joins the backstrap to the base of the hammer. You can see the angle is different. The corner comes higher. It's a smooth corner, but it comes higher than on the other side. So we've got to make some decisions. The owner had looked at some of my previous work and had chosen this Colt as the sample that he wanted. He wanted this top design for the backstrap. I sketched out the design on the top of the piece, but as I suspected, because it had that bulge, it doesn't matter what I do, this is not going to look straight. That middle line coming through the floral design will always look like it's slanted and crooked. I emailed the owner and said, "We have a problem with the backstrap. If I engrave the geometric design as in the Colt sample, the asymmetry of this bulge will be enhanced. It will be much more obvious that the sides don't mirror each other. So, if you like that, no problem. I can engrave it. If you don't like it, I have two concept sketches attached that will camouflage the lack of symmetry. I thought I could make the scroll kind of grow up into the back strap, into the top part." He called me and we talked about the options. He chose the three-pronged scroll. I still wasn't happy with either solution. It seemed a little slapped together, not planned.
"It's crooked. What'd you say?"
"Said it's not straight."
What do you think? What should I do with an uneven backstrap top? Comment below.
This is the beauty of custom engraving. When something like this, an issue comes up, I can communicate with the owner and we can come to a really good solution. And that's the benefits of having something custom done. If you are interested in getting some custom engraving done, start the process by sending me an email. The address is in the description box below the video. We have a solution, and we don't have to make a decision right away because that top part is not going to affect the rest of the backstrap, because that backstrap design I can do. So I'm putting on my Chinese white, and I'm going to sketch out the backstrap. The Chinese white is a watercolor paint that I apply just with mixing it with a little bit of water, and you just keep tapping and smoothing it until it comes out like paper. You want a nice papery finish to be able to do the sketch on. I forgot to turn the camera on for most of the sketching, so you just get to see the last little bit. But here, I will show you the design as it's sketched out. It's kind of hard to get the light to reflect on the pencil, but you can see we've got this middle part that is checkered, and then it grows to the one end. I'm going to leave the top end open, as in I will be able to keep drawing up the backstrap. It's kind of nice, this design, because it doesn't have an up or down direction. I snapped a couple of pictures of this backstrap and sent it off for approval. Must get approval before I cut. You can see I've left the top rather open-ended. I'm not going to sketch that in. The owner loved it. Perfect. Love the look of it. Go ahead and start cutting. Permission has been granted, so I get to cutting the design. This is the engraving process. Now, as I am cutting, every time there is a circle or a swirl, I turn the vise. It's a very much a two-handed operation. If you've watched some of my other videos, this will be repetition for you. But every time I go in to cut a circle, I move the vise into the device. My right hand is handling the graver, and it's handling the bevel and the angle of the cut. But it is my left hand that moves the vise into the graver. So, two-handed. You know, this is a little more complicated than chewing gum and patting the top of your head. So, yes, the right hand controls the bevel, the angle, the overlay of the cut, and the left hand moves the swirl, the circle. The left hand moves the vise. With my foot, I am operating the speed of the hammer because this is an air-powered engraver. So the air, compressed air, goes into the hammer and operates the hammer in the hand tool, and it's way faster than I could ever engrave. You know, I can't hit the hammer that fast. I've split up the engraving of this piece into shorter videos by part of the gun. I should mention that you don't have to get a whole piece engraved at one time. You can start with the cylinder, then the backstrap, and go on to the rest. It's a way of spreading out the costs so that it doesn't come all at once. You know, you can get a piece engraved over years if you wanted to. Something to consider. This is one of the longer engraving parts because we've run out of areas where we're going to put buds coming off the back of the spine. So I have to keep steady and cut, and I don't move the tool. I have to stop when I take my foot off the pedal. I don't move the tool. I only pedal and add power as I'm moving. And so I stop, I move my hand, and then I keep going. Boy, I like the look of that. It's always nice to see something pretty and complete. Now I'm going back in to do the inside of the spine of the scroll. But I have combined the scroll and the checkering. So this in my design, the scroll grows out from the middle towards both ends, and you've got kind of a checkering centerpiece that's almost a diamond shape. And this is unique. I haven't seen anybody else do this design, so it's definitely something. If you see this, you know I've engraved it, because nobody else does this type of design.
Rawhide! Cut him out! Ride him in! Let him in! Let him out! Cut him out!
Here we have a nice long curl coming up the back of the spine of this scroll. Went out of focus. Shoot. Anytime I come to a little bud, that's a chance to break the line. It's a long way to go around the whole thing, and the little buds, they add flourishes. They add a little bit of interest to the whole design, and it's nice to break it up. This particular backstrap design is something that I have come up with, incorporating the scroll and the cross-hatching. That cross-hatch or checkering that you usually find on a Western piece, on pistols, that usually comes somewhere on the front part of the strap. Sometimes they'll have it incorporated in other places in the gun. For our purposes, it's a good thing that this is the design that the owner chose, because it doesn't have an up or down. It grows from the middle to both ends, which means we've got more flexibility with that problematic top part of the backstrap. Are you enjoying this video? Please share it. You would really be helping me out. Sharing, liking, subscribing, and commenting all help with the YouTube algorithm. And it would be nice to get a little income from making these videos. Please do your part to support the show. Thanks. I'll do a video where I talk a little bit more about the equipment and show you the bits and pieces of it. This is just about this backstrap and making it as beautiful as it can be. When all of the surrounding scroll is done, I can get in here and do some of that checkering. Checkering is harder to do than scroll, in my opinion, because you have to have those lines straight. And they have to be the correct angle from the opposite lines. You can't have anything slightly crooked or it'll look really bad. It has to be perfect. You would think straight lines would be easier to do than scroll. Well, there's just a lot of forgiveness with scroll. When that you come around and you're moving and there's a lot of, everybody knows that there's going to be a bit of movement in it. When you're doing straight lines, however, there is no forgiveness. Everybody expects straight lines of engraving to be like their machine done. We've gotten so accustomed to machined engraving that we don't even look twice. I mean, it would be strange if something was a little off. Hand doing things is different. There's uniqueness, and there is a little bit of change. You know, it's the human touch.
Hey, Annie! This sign straight?
Straight as a hare's front tooth.
Straight as a fraidy cat's tail.
The animal kingdom satisfied, I am.
Cutting straight lines and rubbing my finger over to make sure that I don't have any burrs. Don't want any raised portion that's not smooth. You see me doing that very often as I'm engraving. I'm always rubbing it with my finger. Once I've got it all cut, now we're just going to add a little dab of water and take off that watercolor paint. We'll really be able to see the design then, with the paint gone. Just takes a little drop, and that will wash away that water, polish it up. Dot punch. Now, I use the dot punch as the background. So it's going to be filling the negative space of the design. And it is so much simpler to do it this way than to do cross-hatching or even the more expensive way, of course, is to remove the background and to dig out the metal so you have a relief. This gives the relief effect without the expense and time of removing metal. And it's beautiful. You add all those little dots in there into the negative space and it really pops the scroll. There's different levels of detail that you can add. I'm just doing background within the scroll itself. I'm not going to do it out to the edge of the backstrap. So not outside of the scroll, just inside of the scroll. And it gives that nice relief look. Things to know about doing a dotted background like this. You don't overlap your circles. The circles have to be separate, touching but separate. And you don't have place to have half circle because it's really hard not to damage the foreground image that you're trying to pop, you know, if you get too close to the edge. So those are some of the things. Other thing is that it'll bounce, it'll skip. So you can see it sounds like I give two taps to every strike. The first tap is just me making sure that the hammer is right angle to the punch. And then I hit it so that I'm looking down at the work. I'm not looking up at the hammer. So when I touch the head of the hammer to the end of the punch there, I look up just to make sure that everything is at right angles to the, if I'm not hitting it flat, then the punch will skid across the surface. So every hit I check. And I also, you know, that tap makes me know that, okay, I can feel the hammer is level to the punch, which, you know, when you're dealing with a rounded surface, when we do the barrel, then it's always different. You know, it feels different. It's not level to the ground. It's got to be level to the punch. It was here when I'm doing the center part of the little squares and in the crosshatch when I came up with another idea for the top of the backstrap. Just another couple of hits, and then I think we're done that section. Let's have a look. There we go. Now you can really see that design. You can see how the checkering, the crosshatch, is in the center, and there's a dot punch in the center of each of these little squares. I emailed the owner and said I had a new idea for the top, and the paper sketch is attached. See, I decided to put the crosshatch in between some flourishes on the side. He thought that looked great, so I sketched it out on the piece and then sent that back to him. You can see this is going to camouflage. It's going to make those irregularities in the background negative space. Yep, I agree, he said. So I have the go-ahead. I'm going to cut this new design. I left the top of one of the scrolls open-ended with a bud so that I could come in there and let the scroll grow up the back and into that, those nice flourishes on the side, kind of a fan look. I don't know what you call it. I have all these designs in my head and not the words to describe them, but I call them flourish fan, or, you know, in my head. I've got more pictures of pieces I've done on my website, theartistengraver.com, on Instagram and Facebook. Check the video description below for links. One thing about cutting the top of this backstrap, I've got it into the vise very nicely snug, but I'm still pushing on the top of that metal and it's got a little bit of a spring to it. So you could see just when I released there, it kind of bounced up. Have to make allowances for that and realize that I'm going to have some give because I don't want to have my graver skate across the surface when it bounces up and cause some scratch. Just, it's very much an art that you have to be feeling the way of the piece, or there can be errors very easily. Here we go, coming around in that nice big scroll and going to the center. And I'm doing it slower because I don't want to deal with the bounce. And I want to make sure that that's nice and smooth because that's going to be a feature point at the top of this backstrap. The nice thing about doing the top of the backstrap is I can get it centered on the vise, and so every turn is very convenient for me. It's not like I'm doing a barrel of a gun where, you know, I'm trying to accommodate a real long or real wide circle of rotation. This is very compact, and that's nice when you're dealing with something this fragile or this sensitive to any error. Next video will show the design and engraving of the barrel on this Colt. Click the subscribe button and hit the bell so you will be notified when that video is posted. Once I have the outside scroll done, I come back in and do all of those nice straight lines so that I get the little boxes of the checkering. I'm trying to hold it up a little bit with my finger so I don't have as much of a give, because any kind of give when I push down and the hammer is going against that metal, that'll cause the graver to shake. And then I don't have straight lines. I've got squiggly, you know, as the top of the backstrap bounces up and down, then you can get a crooked line very quickly. Let's take that Chinese white off and see what we have. Just a little bead of water is enough to wash it off. Want to get that dried as soon as possible because we are dealing with open steel. I'll be waxing this. I'll be putting some of that Renaissance wax on everything. There we go. So now I have to come in and fill in the background of the scroll with the dot punch. Do you have any questions? Drop them in the comments below. And so that it matches the other checkering, I'm putting a little dot in each of the squares of the checkering. There we go. Oh, that looks really good. I think it turned out well. It sure nicely sparkles. You can see how each of those lines picks up the light. It's very nice. That's beautiful.
Oh, my rifle, my pony, and me.
Hey, that's real pretty. Go on and play some more.
You can see the top of the back strap and how that goes down into the secondary checkering, and then it grows down to the bottom. It fills it in. This finishes the pattern. It doesn't look like it's misplaced or out of place. It looks like it belongs. This is the design that needed to be on this gun. It turns that around the crooked part into negative space, so you don't even see it when you're looking at the scroll. It's great. The owner was very pleased. He said, "I like that pattern even better than the geometric we were going to do originally." I agree with him. I do too.
The backstrap of this Colt third generation single action army pistol turned out great. It's all starting to come together. Send me an email if you are interested in getting some gun engraving for yourself. It makes a great gift to get or to give. I can ballpark an estimate for you. Click this link if you are interested in seeing some more ideas about pistols, and this link for the 7 steps to getting your gun engraved. See you next time.